go as we've got them seated down.
And looks like another button check going on here, but looks like we might get a Leo versus Potemkin matchup.
Oh, and this is a tough one if these are the correct characters here. Potemkin, I would say, a little behind in this matchup. I would say it's slightly Leo's favor. The big thing is if the Leo starts to throw fireballs, he's going to have a bad time.
Absolutely.
You have to be. It is a great anti-zoning fireball, and it is great for guaranteed meaty setups. But if you are throwing fireballs in neutral, Potemkin is going to eat you alive. Slide head, flick. There are so many things that can come through to stop it. That and Potemkin has to navigate the DP, which is, I think, the hardest part for most characters in this matchup.
And another thing to add on to that with the projectile, while the projectile is multi-hitting, which is great for breaking armor, they are so incredibly slow. Well, like you said, just makes it so easy for Potemkin to flip. And here we go. Already, Sankola, Potemkin, putting in the pressure here.
Okay. Tried to go for the hammer stop. Looked for the PRC. Yeah, PRC afterwards, the burst comes through. He's able to backdash and get his own throw. Continue to keep him pressed in the corner. The Kara Garudas, and yes, that is how fast a round can end. One overextension there from Leo, and it gets closed out right away.
Yeah, when you see the Kara Garuda for Potemkin, you know that the fear of God is in you. And they slide his time just a little too early here, but gets him with the JD immediately going into Mega Fist.
Okay, looks like 2K2D, not gonna happen. Didn't get the stagger there on the 2S. You poke with 2S looking for max damage there.
And Steak Fox with the counter hit 2D. Sankola had to burst there, did not want to stay in the corner, and the quick air throw.
Oh, was going for the close slash, it does not work out. Look for the dash through and establishing early in the first game as well. That run through is not an option. That's Sankola doing an amazing job being able to stop all of those options, being able to, you can't cheese turns against Potemkin.
Absolutely not, and that's a quick first game too. Immediately with the 2S around start, and there you go, Slidehead. Slidehead is going to really stop a lot of Leo's approach here.
5P, great for the anti-air. Always a trade in your favor. Oh, the overhead gets the open up here. Presses to the corner. Presses advantage. Gets a good amount of real estate and takes him for the last ride.
Yeah, but there it is with the wall break too. No, holds him there just a little bit.
Okay, a little bit of an extra reset there. Extra damage. Positive bonus coming through now. But, oh,
the
no!
The classic.
Oh, something you're going to see quite often here. Able to close the gap a little bit, but there is the DP we talked about. You can't disrespect Leo. When Leo's on his back, it's still his turn. You've got to respect it.
All right, Mega Fist backwards and immediately forward. Gets the burst really early on. That is a great win for Sankola.
I'm willing to call that the shimmy, the back forward. Oh, no, off the clash, he's able to cancel. Look at the damage now.
Oh, my God.
The back Mega Fist
and the Potemkin Buster. He's going to take it there.
Dude, so much there. And I love the adjustment to that combo because Kara forward back Mega Fist is generally the optimal thing you see there. But he knows the route will work even without the Kara. So he just makes it easier on himself. That is really great game knowledge. But unfortunately, it's not going to help out with the Whiff Gold Burst.
Yeah, Steak Fox not going down without a fight here. Gets the parry and goes straight into Super. That's going to be a wall break.
Got him with the Toaster Strudel.
Not quite enough to kill, though. Potemkin, a big, beefy boy with lots of guts here.
2D, yeah, 2D into DP. Very classic stuff here in Strive. PRC goes low again. Low into a PRC, checks him on his legs again. I think normally when you see the low and the immediate PRC, you're thinking he's got something tricky for me.
Absolutely, and one thing you're noticing, we mentioned before about fireballs, Steak Fox is not throwing them out.
Yes.
It completely taking them out of the arsenal, pretending that they don't exist, just trying to get on top of Potemkin and keep that pressure going.
He threw one fireball to put him off kilter, and it was perfectly timed. And that's all you really need here. Just enough to let him know that you're willing to do it, but not enough to commit to it. So just like that, at that range, that's a perfectly good fireball.
And there's another big counter hit 2D. Picks up the 2K. Potemkin a little too heavy to get the run through the combo, though.
Forced to burst, both burst off the table very early. Try to go for the 2D combo. Oh, he's gonna spend the PRC.
Yeah, wants to push him all the way into the corner here, and there's the pop buster, and that's death.
Yeah, even if it wasn't 6K into Garuda, gonna have a bad time on the next mix-up. So now, Sankola trying to take this. Close slash into Garuda, not gonna happen. If Leo is charging, you cannot steal turns like that.
But the wake-up throw there from Sankola pushed all the way into the other corner here. A big counter hit 2D. This time, instead of going for the run through, goes for another option, works out.
Backdash didn't work out. PRC, close slash this time to punish the attempt at jumping out.
YRC, run through immediately, and the dash through too.
Got him with the counter hit again. Continuing this pressure, the new buff shoot with the dash through is so strong. This is gonna be positive bonus here. Steak Fox. Got to try and take it home, but no!
The absolute patience there from Stayfox not to just immediately press a button or try to go for a run through after the wall break was incredible.
Then nothing. PRT nothing. Had to wait two ways to answer. He tried to go for the JD, but unfortunately it does not work out. Final round.
Here we go, creating a little bit of space. No punish on the Hammerfall there.
Good trade. Always, if you're on your back and Potemkin standing, it's a great trade.
All right, tries to go for the 6H. Oh, PRC straight into Potbuster.
And PRCing that late can punish most not invincible moves there. So that is a very well-informed mix-up.
6P straight.
Oh, dude, the new buff, 6P Heat Knuckle, way to close it.
Can't believe they gave him that, man.
He needs it. He needs it.
6P Heat Knuckle.
Even on block,
it's terrifying.
The craziest thing about it is if he does 6P and he blocks it, he can still cancel. If he does 6P and they're too high for Heat Knuckle, which is an astronomical situation, I wouldn't believe there would be a situation, you can still just Garuda. So you can get combos off of just about anything. If you have another, if you have an RC, you can do 6P Mega Fist forward. There's just so many options you get off of that.
He's got the Garuda shirt too. You see that? Showing it off already. Wearing it proud. And you're seeing those Kara Garudas are putting in so much work. When you get knocked down by Potemkin, just the fear of, do I have to block Garuda or is he going to Potemkin Buster me? That is what the whole matchup is almost.
Absolutely. Oh, Kara back Mega Fist. It's the first counter hit. 6K from that distance is safe.
Jumps out at that time.
Two burst. A burst coming off the table very early. That has been the meta this weekend for sure. We're bursting on first hit almost always from just about everyone.
Well, yeah, I mean, with such a high damage game, having that early momentum is so important that I can't blame anyone for bursting that early. And there's a Potemkin Buster, just enough damage.
That, and you saw reversal timing come up on Stakebox. Whatever he went for, gets scooped straight out of it. Set point again. Try to go for the round start Pop Buster. I like the attempt, but not going to happen.
The backdash there on the overhead back turn from Leo.
Very nice. Kara Garuda for the second one. Jumps in with just JK. Okay.
PRCing, there's the 2H punish. This is Matt. Drops it, unfortunately. Just a little too far away when going for that run through.
Then for Santa Cola, unfortunately, I don't think that was an intended fast RC. I think he just accidentally got it because fast RC was the only reason he got hit there.
And he has to hold this Garuda now.
Yeah, 2D into DP. You've got to know by now.
It's old reliable for Leo.
Backdash into the throw. Another classic, but he's going to burst.
Yeah, he wants this.
He checked him again with 2P.
Oh, the JS! Pulling it out in last second, coming in clutch there.
Dude, round three. We've got to see how we finish here. Looking for the 2S's again. Great slide head. And the Pop Buster straight away. That's a third of your life. Two more interactions here. He's going to do it again.
Is he going to go for a third?
2K, 2D incoming. Oh no, the close slash is enough to open it up. And that is how the rounds can go. Potemkin, sometimes the boy just eats.
That man, he needs to eat. You see how big he is?
Dude, I mean, that's what I'm saying. He's got a lot of calories.
Bro, too many calories.
Oh, dude. But he's got the shirt. Let's go, dude. Showing off the Garuda. We love to see that, dude.
Look, I don't know. It